Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create the look of a custom wax seal and how to change its color. I provided this close-up image of an old tattered envelope that you could use for this project. Its link is in the video's description or project files. Before we begin, if you want to know as soon as I upload new Photoshop tutorials, smash that subscribe button, and please remember to click like if you like this video. Thank you. Click the new layer icon to make a new layer. Open your elliptical marquee tool and go to the center of your document. Press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag out a circular selection from the center, approximately this size. Click the foreground color, and in the color picker, type into the hexadecimal field A3 and 4 zeros. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. Press Alt or Option plus Delete to fill it with that color. Deselect it by pressing Ctrl or Command D. Later, I'll show you how to change the color of your entire wax seal quickly and effectively. We'll convert the red circle into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively and allow us to make changes to it at any time if we want. To do this, click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. Double-click an empty area of the layer to open its layer style window. Click Bevel and Emboss. The style is inner bevel, the technique is smooth, and the depth is 100%. The direction is up, the size is 50 pixels, and soften is 0. Use global light is unchecked, the angle is 90 degrees, and the altitude is 60 degrees. The gloss contour is linear. The highlight mode is screen, the color is white, and the opacity is 85%. The shadow mode is multiply, the color is black, and its opacity is 30%. Click Contour. Click the arrow to open the presets, and click the gear icon. Click Small List, and click Half Round. The range is 50%. Click Drop Shadow. Click the color box, and type in 3E1100. Then click OK. The blend mode is normal, and the opacity is 60%. Use global light is unchecked. The angle is 130 degrees. The distance is 10 pixels. The spread is 0, and the size is 20 pixels. The contour is linear. Go to Filter, Distort, and Wave. Feel free to play with the setting amounts. For this example, I'll set the number of generators to 1, the wavelength 1 and 345, the amplitude 1 and 91, and the scale 100%. The type is sine, and repeat edge pixels. Let's collapse the effects to save some space. Make a new layer. Go to the center of the shape and as before, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag out a circular selection approximately this size. To reposition it, keep pressing and holding Alt or Option plus Shift and press and hold the space bar to drag the selection. Then fill the selection with the foreground color and deselect it. Convert it to a smart object. Double-click an empty area of the layer to open its layer style window. Click Bevel and Emboss. For the direction, tick down and make the size 16 pixels. Make the highlight opacity 90% and the shadow opacity 50%. Click Contour. Change the contour to linear. Control or Command click the circle to select its shape. make layer 1 active, and Alt or Option click the layer mask icon to make an inverted layer mask of the selection. Make the top layer active. Next, we'll add text or design to the center of our wax seal. Open a high resolution, high contrast, black and white design that you'd like to convert into a wax seal. I downloaded this one from Shutterstock. If you'd like to use just text instead of a design, I'll show you how to do that in a minute. To ensure that the design is 100% black and white, open Levels by pressing Ctrl or Command L. If the input black and white levels aren't aligned along the left and right edges of the histogram, drag the input black level slider to the point where the histogram levels out. Drag the input white level slider near the center to ensure it's pure white. Unlock the layer and open the Channels panel. If you don't see it, go to Window and Channels. Control or Command-click the thumbnail of any of the channels to select the shape of the design. Press the Delete key on your keyboard to delete all the white areas. Then deselect it. Press V to open your Move tool and drag the design onto the tab of the wax seal. Without releasing your mouse or pen, drag it down and release. To resize it, open your Transform tool by pressing Control or Command T. Go to a corner. In version CC 2019 and later, press and hold Alt or Option as you drag it in or out. In earlier versions, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it. Position it to the center, then press Enter or Return. To finesse its position, you can move it one pixel at a time by pressing the arrow keys on your keyboard. If you want to type in text instead, first, make sure your foreground color isn't the color of your wax seal, otherwise we won't be able to see it. The quickest way is to just invert the foreground and background colors by pressing X on your keyboard. Open your horizontal type tool and type Picker. Pick any font you like and type out your text. To reposition it, open your Move tool and move it. The last steps are the same for text or design. Reduce the fill to 0%. Doing this makes our text or our design invisible, but it'll retain the full visibility of the layer styles we'll be adding to it. Double-click an empty area of the layer to open its layer style window. Click Bevel and Emboss. The style is Emboss, the technique is Smooth, and the depth is 200%. The direction is up, and I'll make the size 12 pixels, but you may want to adjust this depending on the characteristics of your design or text. Basically, make it size whatever looks good to you. Make the shadow's opacity 40%. Lastly, I'll show you how to quickly change its color. We'll place all of the wax seal layers into a folder by shift-clicking the bottom shape to make all the wax seal layers active and pressing Ctrl or Command G. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Hue Saturation. Adjustment layers affect all the layers below them in the Layers panel. If we want an adjustment layer to affect just the one layer below it, we need to clip it or restrict it to that layer. To do this, click the clipping mask icon or go to Layer and create Clipping Mask. Check Colorize. I'll increase the saturation to 60, but feel free to adjust this if you like. Drag the Hue slider across to a color you like. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.